God, we give you praise and thanks for letting us see another day. Thank you, God. Just give us our daily bread. Lead us in the way of righteousness. And don't lead us in the way of temptation. Keep us from evil. God, keep us washed. God, we haven't got to heaven yet. God, the scribes and Pharisees, probably all of us in this place today, our righteousness put all together wouldn't succeed theirs, but they missed it. God, I want the God of Abraham and of Isaac and Jacob, I want to abide in you, Father, Lord Jesus. I want your word to abide in me. God, the Pharisees was good, but they missed it. God, I'm not counting on, because I come out of the world, that to save me. I'm not counting on, Lord, because it, I have no desire for nothing out there in the world. God, I got to have the blood. I got to have the blood of Jesus daily. The bread of life daily to keep me going, God. Look upon everyone here and you see their hearts. While you're breaking up my hard ground, my fallow ground, break up theirs. Give us a meek and a quiet and a contrived spirit, a spirit subject to you. Oh God, Lord Jesus, we haven't got there yet. God, we pray that you'll do something to turn this whole area around. God, we pray, and it's this whole country. Lord Jesus, send your word. Lord, you sent your word ahead of you. Send your word ahead of us. Before you came, you sent your word and delivered them out of all their troubles. God, help us through the blood of your only begotten Son to turn around and to realize that our self-righteousness is not going to get us there. Lord, not a one of us here, myself and everyone here, can hold a flashlight to the scribes and Pharisees. But hardly none of them, maybe Nicodemus, could have been about the only one that made it. Oh God, help us. But he slipped to over at night to see you, Jesus. Oh Jesus, you told him he had to be born again. God, I want to be born again and born again and again and again. Thank you, Jesus. You told me in the beginning to stay little. Father, help me. God, I pray. Stir up my soul. Everybody out there, ask God to break up that old hard spirit in you. That old fallow hard. Fallow's hard. You can't even get a turning plow in it. You know, you probably don't know what that is. That's when we had mules and horses and had a turning plow. Oh, God. Get that old hard spirit out of us, Lord, and let us realize we didn't save you, God. You saving us. In the name of Jesus. Lord, you even told us by one of your apostles that our righteousness is filthy rags. Oh, God, help me not to have filthy rags. Jesus. Do something, God. Lord, turn this area around. God, it's like it's fell from grace. Lord, there used to be hundreds of people. We know many of them went on to be with you. But God revive, as David said, this place again. Revive it again, Lord. Oh, Lamb of God, Mighty One of Israel, glory to the King of Kings. And God, please, before we leave, before this week is over, as we go into this new week, God, we pray. We pray, God, that every solitary one of these prayer requests to be answered. Lord, we know that the righteous pray. The Lord hears him. Cleanse me, Lord. Purify me by the washing of the water of the Word. Sanctify me by the Holy Ghost and by the Word. Lord, that my righteousness won't be filthy rags. God, that it be the pure salvation of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Glory to your name. God in heaven, give us ears to hear. Lord, you said we got ears, but we don't hear what the Spirit's saying. God, give us ears to hear what the Spirit's speaking to the church. Lord, this ain't no it could be, or maybe it is. It is the way, the truth, and life. God, it is. You are Jesus, our salvation. You are the Almighty that said, let's build this church upon this rock, and the gates of hell can't prevail against it. God, all the way across this country, everywhere we go, churches, it's closing up, boards nailed over the doors everywhere, Lord, to the two biggest Pentecostal churches in the world. God, help us. Help us, Lord. Get us back to the old landmark. Sanctify me again, Lord. In the name of Jesus. God, I beseech you, I beg you. You told Israel 2,000 years ago that if they didn't hear you, Jesus, that you're going to take the kingdom from them and give it to a nation. Give it to a nation that's going to bring the fruits. I believe America was that country 110 years ago, and maybe a little more, a little less. God, now we losing it again. Oh, Jesus. God, the revival we should be having in America is happening in Mexico, Lord. It's happening in Africa. And Lord, I don't grudge it. I thank you, God, that you've opened up doors. But we need you. If I reach out to the Lord a minute or two and reach out, let God know that you want him to break up your grounds. Let God know that you don't think you got it made. God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I know I got some enduring. God, I know I got to fight some more. God, I know I got to resist. Stand still and know that you're God. In all the name of Jesus. And I do pray for these needs. If you got a need, and maybe you need somebody to pray with you, if it's nothing but yourself, that you know you need God to restore your first love and to revive you again. God, I pray right now, who's got an uplifted hand, revive them again. Grant their petition. Answer their needs. Break up their fallow grounds. Sanctify them all over again and me with it. Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Be it so, Lord, be it so. We're giving you the praise. All in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Reach over and take somebody's hand. Tell them, I just want to be saved. You know, I made my mind up a long time ago. Could have tried to be this and that. I said, Lord, I made a covenant with the Lord. I said, God, I just want to be saved. I ain't out here trying to get a crown. I just want to be saved. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Oh, God, I beseech you, Lord. Wash us and keep us. Praise his name. Praise his name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I still believe Jesus saves. Oh, and your blood washes us whiter than snow, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. God, I beg you, Lord, this as we finish up this year, send your word ahead of us. Lord, make us through you, God, more than a conqueror to this formality that's took over the church world. God, as one of your servants said, revive us again that your people may rejoice in you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I still told you when I started out, God, like Job, though you slay me, I trust you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Praise his name. Praise his name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Jesus. Reach over and take somebody's hand, and I'm going to get you to repeat something. I said, it sure is hot in here. But it's going to be hotter than hell in here. Man, I'm telling you. I just want to go to heaven, don't you? I just want to go to heaven, but his old boy said, but not right now. I ain't quite ready. I ain't got my tie on. I ain't got my suit I want to be wearing. Give me a little more time. Let me tie my shoes or something. Praise God. Hallelujah. I just want to be ready. That's a good song somebody wrote. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise his name, praise his name. Oh, how I appreciate him. Thank the Lord, thank the Lord. Thank the Lord, thank the Lord. I just feel like something inside my head, and especially on my right side, is like trying to make my hair stand up on my head. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I know it's the fear of God. I feel it. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Glory. You know, God will watch after you. God will watch after. I was checking in. I do a lot overseas, and I was doing more then. And I was checking in and had a ticket. And something told me don't ride this flight in my heart. And it left an hour earlier. And it was coming from overseas, and I was wanting to get back. Went on down to the next corner, and I showed they wouldn't take my ticket. I said, well, I got the money in my pocket, I'll buy another one. And we landed in New York about 12 hours later. And we got to the gate, the pilot come on and said, that flight that left, just 350 people went down in that ocean. You know, if we'll live for God, he'll watch after. One time, someone come up and had a long barrel pistol. Someone to shoot you. I said, shoot. They pulled that trigger and it snapped. Cut it up like that and that pistol went off. They fell on their face, cried and wept. Give their lives to Jesus. There was up in Oklahoma. I heard 10, 15 years later that they were dying. I went up there on a real chartered plane, went up there, and as that nurse could have said, went in and shook their hand, prayed with them, and thank you, Jesus. They pointed up, said, I'm ready to go. Walked out of the room, nurse went in there, come back out and said they were dead. You know, you just don't know. Thank you. When I heard about that, I wanted that person to know that they were forgiven. You know, when you get to meet that old judgment seat, it's going to take more than looking like a Christian. Scribes and Pharisees, every one of us in this place today, put together, including myself, me and you, when it comes to outside wholeness, we couldn't hold them scribes and Pharisees a shadow. Nicodemus is the only one that I read about, and he snuck over at night. Didn't want the rest of them to see him, I don't guess. But after that, he didn't care, did he? When Jesus told him, you must be born again, man, he started looking his mama up. Hallelujah. Glory to him in the church, supposed to be like a mama. Thank you, Jesus. And he made it. Thank God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I know people get tired of me talking like this, but I don't care. I just want to go to heaven. And I see so many people trying to get in because they've been in church now for a long time, and they look good, and but for some reason, they're not contacting. If you can't get on your knees or walk the floor with a prayer of adrenaline prevailing in your heart, you having this struggle to pray, you need to do something another where you can pray. The little old, I lay me down to sleep prayer, they're going to get it done. Bible teaches us to pray in season and out of season. And if you come to him with a broken spirit and a contrite spirit, thank God. And you won't be praying very many days till you be bawling. I said, Mama, I've been rebuked for that. They said that ain't a proper word, but I don't care if it ain't. My mama told me, she's raising me up, if I didn't bawl, she whooped me again till I got a broken spirit. And that's what we got to do. How many times have your mama or daddy whooped you to get you a broken spirit? Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Now, you see that little baby on her? man to me, you could become like that. We'll have the wings of an angel. She is so sweet. That's the way the Bible said we got to become. Thank the Lord. I want to go to Mexico. I always love seeing him down there and them kids. Praise God. That little girl and that little other kid too. But boy, that little girl is so, just looked like she just a little creature for the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I don't know whether God woke me up or not. I know people said God woke me up this morning, but whether he did or not, I woke up. And that scripture came to me. He that endure to the end. I preach about that a lot. I tell you, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, please give us that joy and peace and righteousness in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Don't you appreciate him? Oh, I appreciate him. I appreciate him. I appreciate him. Thank you, Jesus. I want to give you an opportunity if you can help us, if you wish to. We need your help. And God will bless you. And what you give will help us to people like you and to keep this journey for the Lord. Man came and stood in my bed and said it was Jesus and I was healed, and I thank God. My little brother saw it, and boy, he bailed out. Got my mom about a mile over up in Conch. She walked in that door, and I was still walking and running. And first thing she done, lifted my hands up to heaven and said, Jesus, never doubted you one time. Praise you. Cut that on me. I want you to start the recorder. Thank the Lord at the beginning for me. Start at the one. Thank you, Jesus. God, we thank you for this day. God, I pray that you'll revive this place again. Lord, put us back up on this rock, Lord, where the gates of hell can't touch it, can't prevail against it. Oh, Jesus. Lord, this whole Brownwood, this every this little place out here, Lord. And think about it, Lord. All Texas is going through it. Jesus, we ask you for mercy. God, have mercy upon us. In the name of Jesus. I mean, I saw what happened in Dallas on your TV or your news. Don't that frighten you? I told people all that going to be happening. And I told people this thing going to start in Texas, didn't I? And people better listen to what I'm saying. I'm not saying it because I'm just saying it. It's because God's saying it through me. We got trouble ahead. I told people this thing. And I told them it's going to start right there in Dallas. We need Jesus. I said, we need Jesus, folks. I said, we need Jesus. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, do bless this word. We ask you, God, to open up our hearts. Open up our minds. Get us ready, Lord, for this great second coming of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. I want to read this verse here, and I might read it some more. It's Malachi 3. Behold, I send my messenger. He shall prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord. I believe with all my heart, God's been having me to go through these scriptures. Even this in Isaiah 6, it's been a blessing to me when it said, in the year that King Uzziah died, which was a great man of God, I saw the Lord sent upon a high throne. Went on to say, verse 8, I heard a voice. Isaiah said, who will go for us? I've been hearing that voice over and over everywhere I go. God needs men and women that'll humble ourselves and say, Lord, here am I. God can't use selves. Who shall I send? Can God depend upon you? One thing about it, since Jesus come on the scene, we know that back in the under the law, the women had to sit on one side of the church and the men on the other, and the woman was sort of put behind. But when Jesus came on the scene, he made no respect to person of nationality, a man, a woman. He made us all equal. I said he made us all equal. Thank you, Lord. We know we're not all preachers, but we need some Isaiahs. Then said I say that to the Lord almost every day. God, hear my glory. Thank you, Jesus. You just don't know. It's a sacrifice. It's hard sometimes to give your soul and your life and your body to the Lord. It's not easy. I said it's not easy. The world has not heard the gospel yet. Well, they've heard bits of it, but they still want to what they say. There's still 37 to 40 something countries that's never heard that name one time. Most of them Africans. Only 2% of the most populated area in the world, only 2% of them have heard the gospel. Over 1 billion people in that country has never heard the gospel. I was reading, I've heard people say, well, Jesus could come tomorrow. I said, no, he couldn't if he's going to live by the book. I was reading, God needs people like you and others that don't try to be something. Just say, God, here am I. That's what you said in the Bible. Remember that? You remember when men and women both said, Lord, here am I. Send me. Here am I. Send me. God needs you. Send that sister there. She's been in some of the Indian, African meetings. She'll tell you how hungry them people are. Flew over being an usher here to help and help them in prayer lines. They're so hungry for the Lord. They're like little babies. You ever work with a chicken farm. You ever work where they raise chickens? I have, and we had them at home too, but I worked at a chicken farm. You walk out of that bucket and you say, chick, 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 and them boogers are coming from everywhere. That's the way they are now. You say, chick, 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 here they come out among the brushes. Mud huts, crawling out, little old doors, you know. Down like that, they crawl in there at night, made out of mud, sleep on the ground. When them meetings break out, you see them crawling out of them little, them doors, hungry. And it scares me when I look around and see such a country as America, yeah, that once was 98% believed in Jesus Christ, before this guy that's up there right now, that's the president. Well, I won't call him president myself. I'll call him a nobody, because he has destroyed this country for his Christianity. And now, they say from 6 to 8, 12% at the most believes in Jesus in this country in 8 years, less than 8 years. Yeah. That came out in January. 7 years. We need God, people. God, if we can do something. The Bible said all nations forget God, and this is number one. God's going to turn it when he hits this country. He said, I'm going to visit them with whirlwinds. I'm going to visit them with earthquakes. God's quieting things down a little bit. But we're fixing to see the worst of the worst. And our only hope is for you and me to fall on our faces before God and ask God to give us not your armor, but that whole arm of God, that we may be able to stand. You're not going to stand just because you're a pastor or a preacher or evangelist, or you're a deacon or you're a Sunday school teacher. You're going to stand according to what you got from God in your heart. The scribes and Pharisees, Nicodemus was the only one out of every one of them, and he snuck over there by night to see Jesus. And said, are you the one that should come? Or do we keep looking for another? Thank you, Lord. I was reading about that this morning. It touched my soul. It said, John sent me over here. He said, you go tell him. The blind see. The lame walk. The deaf hear. And the poor. Not people down on Fancy Avenue. Not the biggest churches in the world. It's built in the rich areas. They want you all to, you look in these poor areas. The churches are rotting down. You know why? People don't want a food eat. People that Jesus said the poor have the gospel. You know why the poor have the gospel? The preachers is moving the churches. And God's fixing to take this thing away from folks. A church building ain't going to save you down there. It's going to be a broken and a contrite spirit. It's going to be coming back to that first love that God so loved the world that he gave his son. It's going to take that first love, if you ever got genuine, purified, born of the water and of the Spirit, and filled the Holy Ghost, then God, you didn't get that without the love of God. People have lost almost all these Pentecostal churches across this country that ain't become like Baptist and Methodist, they've become so caught up that because that they look holy, they're holy. There ain't nobody in the world right now, ain't a one here, and ain't a one in America, and a one in nowhere else could even hold them scribes and Pharisees and them Sadducees a flashlight. Man, they looked holy more than me and you and all of them put together in one package. But they missed it. They missed it. For behold, the day come that shall burn as an oven. And all the proud, and yet all that do iniquity shall be scattered. Doing wickedly shall be scattered. The day that come shall burn them up, saith the Lord. That there shall be neither root nor branch. But to you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. You shall grow forth, you shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stall. You shall tread down the weak, tread down the wicked, for they shall be ashes on the soles of your feet in the day that I shall do this, saith the Lord of hosts. And he went on and said, remember Moses. Moses came on the scene at 80 years old. As a forerunner of Jesus Christ after hundreds and hundreds of years. Oh God, how we need some forerunners, how we need, and one thing about it, since Jesus came, he didn't put the women on the back seats. You know, the law, the women had to sit on one side, the temple, and the men on the other. But Jesus tore down the wall of partition, didn't he? Made us all, and he didn't divide up the races. Up to that time, nobody but Jews had even a chance. Jesus, but do we appreciate that? Do we actually appreciate? You know what some of you are doing? You're letting good grace have no effect upon you. You're letting the death of Jesus and the lashes on his back. You go to the doctor and instead to him that by those lashes you were healed. And you ain't got to pay a bunch of money for it either. You know what kind of gospel y'all have, most of you, across this country? Is the gospel. A pill you take for your gospel. A pill you take for your headache. A pill and a shot in the arm for your healing. Jesus is your pill. Jesus is the Lord that heals you. You'll never be healed putting your faith in a medical. Not that I'm teaching against them. You'll never. Jesus is the Lord that heals you. If you get a divine healing and stay healed, it's going to be because Dr. Jesus healed you. It's going to be because the doctor of doctor and the king of kings, praise God, turned his back to the smiters and they lacerated him. No man ever lived that took that whipping. Yeah. to get up from the whipping pole, but a man called Jesus, history says. Not only did he get up from that whipping pole, he took that cross. They put that cross on him. He made it 3/4 up that impossible mile. It was a mile to the top of the hill where they crucified people. He made it nearly to the top. You know why God's moving right now for Africa? A black man. Not a white man, not a Jew, not somebody that went to the first church, but a black man by the name of Simon, running beside Jesus, saw that, went over there and got under that load. God spoke to me in a vision years ago. He said, in the latter times, I'm taking the gospel and I'm sending it back to Simon's people. He's doing it right now. Hallelujah! I said hallelujah! Oh, hoko, hoko! How come I know how high yah? Oh, bakalilo, afiru basta. Jesus said to Israel, "The kingdom shall be taken from you." They had it now for 2,000 years. Somebody asked me, "Why? But what do you think what's going to happen to Jews?" Well, I'm just standing with the scriptures. He said, "Marvel not, Nicodemus. He was a Jew. You got to be born again." Told him, "Everybody ain't born again. Going to be what? Cast into the lake of fire." And everybody that is born again, they ain't gonna be Jew, they ain't gonna be Simon's seed, they're gonna be born again, washed in the blood, purified by the Holy Ghost, no prejudice, no difference. Hallelujah. All have been baptized. We all now are brothers and sisters. Glory be to you. You know what I'm telling you? When you get into this, you brothers and sisters, you don't look at what you see. What you don't see down in here is what you look at. Hallelujah. If you don't want that kind of salvation, you just well to go get you a bunch of ice and a whole bunch of something else and hope they fill that grave and hope somebody drills a hole down to hell where you're going and drop that ice down there maybe the last a minute or two. I don't care if they don't like this kind of preaching. That's the only kind that's going to get you to heaven. You ain't going to get to heaven by all these religions because you look it. I believe you get saved, you ain't about to tell how to look. You'll look right anyway.
Yeah.
I got saved. You know how boys are and still do, I guess. We used to run around our shirts off in the summertime. Mom and I lived, my brother was a Baptist preacher, and he was about 2 or 3 blocks above us, a quarter of a mile or so. I went up there. He was out there in the yard with his shirt off, busting stove wood, you know. You probably know what that's all about. They cut them and put them on stump and bust them, you know. Because back then, not too many people had electric stuff. And his name was Barnard. I went up to him, and I called him Barnard. I went up to him, I said, "I got to find out something." I said, "I've been thinking, you know how kids all run around just their no shirts on? I want to find out, is it wrong?" I said, "I've been feeling like it's wrong for me to run around without my shirt on. I feel like it's a sin. I want to know." You know what he done? He didn't have no shirt on. He looked at me and he said, "David, it's God." He said, "I've been feeling the same thing and I'm glad you came to me." He went in the house right then. He split wood, got him a shirt and some shoes on. Come back out there. Man, by that time I done half a mile out of sight, flying like I was a flying saucer. Man, I went in, busted, and I've been wearing my shirts ever since. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I know it ain't all in clothes, but I don't believe you that God wants you to run around like monkeys. If you do, he filled you, covered you up with hairs like monkeys, wouldn't he? Don't you believe that? Yeah. Hallelujah, and you'd have a long tail like a monkey. But anyway, I'm just glad, praise God, that holiness is still holiness, but that by itself ain't going to do it. Outward holiness, it's good, but unless you get that inner man, you get that inner holiness, unless you get God in you, unless you get Christ in you, unless you get crucified inside and quit looking at others, thinking you better get that old man dead, crucify him, sanctify him, hallelujah, and get him filled with the Holy Ghost. Glory to God, hallelujah. You're not going to be looking at nationalities. You're not going to be looking that you're better than anybody else. You're just going to be grateful that Jesus Christ has called upon you and beat at your heart, sent you to an altar, convicted you of some of the things you're doing and made you feel wrong about it. But you keep on. You sear the conscience. That old holiness preacher, I come up out there. Said you get to the place you can steal a horse, think you ride it to heaven. That's what he said. He told us that don't you let, because you see somebody else doing something, you'd like to be running around like that. Just be what God wants you to be. Thank God. Don't worry about nobody else. Let God be the inner man. Let God transform you. We know the outward appearance don't save us, but I'll tell you one thing. We're not monkeys. If we did, we'd have a long tail, wouldn't we? Hallelujah. I said, we're not monkeys. We're born again, washed in the blood, come out of the world, be separated. Nicodemus came and said, Lord, what I got to do? You got to come out of the world. He come by night, didn't want nobody to see him. Boy, after that, he didn't care who seen him. After he got born again, he didn't matter all the rest of that bunch. Thank God. He's enjoying himself with the angels, ain't he? Oh, I just want to see that kind of revival again. Somebody asked him a while ago, a while back, said, what's going to happen if all that you're saying don't come to pass? I said, well, all I can say, there won't be no coming of the Lord. They said, what? I said, well, Jesus ain't coming back for nothing. Bible said he's coming back for a church and a people. Didn't he say it? Without spot, a blemish, a wrinkle, or any such thing. So if ain't nothing, no reason to come back if ain't nobody down here doing it. That's just a waste of his time. But we can do it. When I started praying about this, I was scared. One day the Lord came, he's been speaking to me since I was 11. And he came to me and I was in a deep sleep and woke up. And he told me, he said, you can do it. You can do it. We all can do it. God is doing just like he did here. Praise God. He's separating the sheep from the goats. And I believe with all my heart that Jesus has got people sitting in these seats today, that God is probably got blisters on that back part down there. You sit around so much in church. Thank God. I got your back end with blisters all over. It's time to get off of them seats. Get out there on them highways. Let them blisters heal up and get to preaching Jesus. Hallelujah. Is that all right? I throwed all that in for good measure. Don't you want to get out yonder? Thank God you got a testimony. You got a tongue. You know, people just shame you. Say, well, they won't let us talk about Jesus. Get you another job. Man, if I had a job and I can't take Jesus to work with me and a Bible with me while they're about sitting around on their little break to smoke, that I can sit around and read the Bible. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't going to work at that place. me tell you something, people. If we don't get back upon this rock, and this rock is Jesus, and there ain't but one book to read, and that's a King James Authorized, and there is another name, Moffat Translation, them the two periods they are, and all these Bibles that won't say Holy Ghost, you better put them up in the closet somewhere. It's Holy Ghost. He said, I baptize you not with the Holy Spirit, but with the Holy Ghost and with power. If you didn't get power over your baptism, you didn't get the right baptism. I said, if you get the Holy Ghost, you get power with it. You get authority with it. You get an unknown language with it. Hallelujah. I said, you get the akoraha, sori kiaya, bita ristayo, kambaduta, raha, feel the bahosa, akakaka maha, feel God wants to revive this place. I believe it. I believe God sent me here to revive this church. This church is dead. I said, this church is dead. It needs a resurrection. You need to get resurrected. You need to get refilled. You need to get rebaptized. There ain't no such a thing. How many know it could be? It is. It is either right or it's false. And it's working. Look at some of the people here last night. Twisted mouth. So somebody or other, the brother remembered down in Mexico, people that one lady didn't have an eyeball, put my hand. Was you there? Thank you, Jesus. Put my eye over that eye, moved it, and an eyeball. Not because I've got something, it's because there's a higher power. Hallelujah. That he said the believers shall lay hands on the sick and they get well. Now they lay hands on the sick to get worse.
Yes, it's true. It's true, but Terrell, but everything that you say is just right. Yes, sir. The message is for me.
The message for him, and I'm excited for me too. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. How many want to get back to truth? He said, you should know the truth. Truth will set you free. You can be free. Free from what? Sin, sickness, disease. Free from fear.
Hallelujah.
I remember when I was preaching like this in South Alabama. I was preaching about long tongues. And we had an altar to be as long as two of these on each side of the step there. And she come up there and she said to me, Brother Terrell, would you help me get my tongue on the altar? And I looked way down there. I said, do you mean the altar ain't long enough? She said, spiritually it ain't. Bless her little heart, she was so real. I laid a clean handkerchief down there, like that. Told her to put her tongue on it. Took another clean handkerchief, put it on top of her tongue, because I didn't want her to bite me. No, I just said that. But anyway, put it on her tongue and pray for her. I was in Mobile, Alabama. And I said, God, sanctify her holy. You know, people ain't looking at that. No, that we're different from what was I started out. And when I started out, they had another 45 or 6 years on me. Because this thing actually started 1888 and 1898 and 1900. And we're talking about in the 60s. I started in 56 on the biggest tent in the world. And during that time. And that woman, I put my hand on that handkerchief, prayed for the Lord to help her brightly. That was sort of in the spring. I didn't go back to Mobile. I was at that time going back to spring and summer. And I don't know for sure I got this last year, but I will be going. Mobile's been a place that we go into, but I've just been so busy. But anyway, when I went back, the little woman ran up and grabbed me and hugged me. She said, Brother Terrell, it worked. I've really got my tongue under control. Thank you, Jesus. I got it on the altar. Thank you, Jesus. I said, thank you, Jesus. But he's still saying, come unto me. Come unto me, all you that labor. Come unto me. Cast your cares over in Peter. Bring your troubles to me. I don't preach against doctors. I wouldn't probably be here. Maybe. Had 11 operations. They'd done everything but cut my leg. And then had 3 on my throat. Bone cancer got in my jawbone. Thank you, Jesus. God is God. Why can't we come to Him? Why can't we at one time realize heaven ain't here yet? We don't know how much longer. You know, the old age, back yonder in the 50s, most people would have thought, save these for the morning service, if they don't run me off. But anyway, praise God for the Holy Ghost. Praise God. I'm going to stay with the truth. Man, this is halfway stuff won't work. This ain't, how many know it could be? This is either it is or it either ain't. I'm not going to get up and ask, like some of you preachers, what do you think about this? I'm going to say it, what do you think about it? No. It's time, preacher, to get some boldness. You ain't got to say, how many know this is? Could be. How many know what you think about? I ain't caring what you think about. I know that I'm speaking by the Bible, and it's backing me up, and we got to get this stuff out of us. Just God wants you to look like a Christian, but He wants you to be a Christian in your body, in your soul. He wants to clean up that inside. The Pharisees, all of you and you put together, you can hold a light to the Sadducees and Pharisees. But you know what? Nicodemus is the only one out of all of them that got into the kingdom. You know why? He come over to Jesus by night, and Jesus got it fixed. He didn't care what they said then. You get where you want to, praise God with God. You get where you're supposed to and where you got to be. It ain't going to matter what people say. Thank God you go. If you have to walk alone, you lose all your friends. You lose your kinfolks. You might even lose your mama. You might even lose your daddy. Your preacher may even run you off, some of these churches, because some of these preachers don't want truth in their churches anymore. You know why? They run around themselves in them shorts. Somebody asked my mother, they said, what are you? Think about these women running around these little things. I said, well, the Bible said it's a. People look on her and lust, then she has caused them to commit adultery, and she's guilty of it too. So, well, what do you think about these men? They doing it now. There ain't nothing but a bunch of monkeys. You see one of them men running around, I say, hello, monkey. That's all they ought to be ashamed of themselves. You know, we have lost our conscience. You're just doing it to do it. But if you're a Christian, nobody's going to have to tell you. After I got saved, one of my brothers, you know, had kids run around after. I felt it was wrong. And I ain't been saved but a little while. And he said to me, David, it's God. Nobody had to get up no more and tell me I wouldn't go out that front door, especially when the house is around, without a shirt on. So why? It causes, if you cause somebody to lust, then you're guilty of it. I said, you're guilty of it as much as they are. Whether people want to like that or not. Bible said for us to get out of the world, come out of her, talking about this Jezebel church, be separated, serve the Lord, touch not, taste not, handle not. And you know what? We just can't let it go. You know what? One of these days it's going to be too late. When that trump sounds, you may hit your knees. But when Jesus appears in that, what they call the eastern sky, and that could happen, look at everything's happening. There ain't nothing But the mark of the beast, they done got that set up. They done got a chip now with everybody on the face of the earth with a number in it. It's a little chip, big as a grain of rice.
They're talking about it on the news every once in a while now. I seen it on there several times here lately.
On Fox and different ones.
Well, I seen it on KTAB and the other ones.
They talking about putting it.
They talking about the chip. That's what I seen on TV.
Yeah, they go. And you get let go ahead and do it, let them do it. You say, why ain't gonna be able to buy nothing? I tell you one thing about it. You'd be wish you could bought some water in hell. And they're going to buy force. You say, how? I'll tell you the force here in that old belly. That'll do that something deep, and you can't buy none unless you got that chip to pay for it. I've been telling people to move out in the country, learn to live without it, haven't I? I've been telling folks that for what? Over a whole generation. 40 or 50 years. Get out there in the country. Thank God, get you some lamps. We got lamps. We got right now our place is fixed. Some people come over, some people helped us. And our place out there, we don't need their electricity. Thank you, Jesus. They come out on what they done, just tell them others we're totally off of it. Hallelujah. I appreciate people thinking enough of us to do that for us. But praise God, but if you have to get out there and do it the old time way, thank God have you well dug. We used to have to let the well and the windlass take it down there and draw it up. Thank God to go down and get next to a spring. Praise God. Hallelujah. And drink spring water. And it's going to be a force. They ain't going to stick no pistol to you. But after you ain't been able to buy nothing for a while, you ain't got no garden, and they say you better get that chip in you. They put it in the hand. Putting it right here. All they're doing is swipe it across there, and it deducts. And if you have a job, you don't ever see money no more. If you're getting a check from the government, you don't get it no more. They put it in your account, and it ain't money they put. And you go ahead and let that happen. You'll find out when you wake up down yonder in hell with the rest of them. Bible said, whoever takes them, it's a beast. This country is becoming a beast. The whole world is coming like a big old beast. You know it's the truth.
Yes, it is.
It's a beast. You know, beast forces people.
Yes, sir.
That's what beast means. Forces people. We got to have what? Nothing but the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire. God said if we'll strive to get in that straight gate, when Jesus come, there'll be a number that no man can number. And they came out of great tribulations. They came out of great tribulations how? Without the mark of the beast. They came out of great tribulation without bound down to right now they're organizing a new world government, and Obama's right in there with him. Trunk, a donk, a punk, a hunk, a billery, a sillery, a hoary, a huzzies, they just did bad. You wake up! Wake up! Get back to God! I've been telling you that since this church and before it was built, when it had that old Green Hornet. How many remember? We had a tent, they called it the Green Hornet. That's what started this church. Put up down you. Been warning you. People call me by everything. Well, I ain't truth. That's been what? 50 years ago. 40, 50 years ago. How long? 73. How long is that?
34 years.
34 years I've been coming in here. Wake up, people. God ain't got me going all over the world. I'm the only preacher of history that's gone over 200 countries of the world. Not because I'm bigger than anybody. It's because I've got a message. I've got a message. I've got a message that Jesus is Lord. I got a message that the end of the world is upon us. I got a message. Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. I got a message. The moment you take that chip, you just get all the ice you can. Hope I can buy it with you. because you're going to burn in hell. Ain't no way out. They're already buying by numbers already. God will help us if we'll turn to Him. I said, God will help us if we'll come to Him. Get right back to Paul in Ephesians. Put on the whole arm of God that you may or may be able to stand. And we stand. What's coming? We can do it, I believe. But we got to lay our lives down. We got to lay our lives down. We're right now coming right on down to the end of the journey. Oh, God, help us. God, help us. One scripture said, ever learning, never able. If we'll open up our hearts, people, I believe before these days are out here, that God get us back upon that rock. Help us to. You say, well, you've been sinning. Well, the Bible said, be ready 2,000 years ago at all times. For nobody knows. He said that 2,000 years ago. He said, well, why have you gone? Well, somebody picked this mantle up. Somebody surely will carry this message. Jesus wants you. And you can lay your lives down right here in these altars. You can say, Lord, I'm going to come the Jesus way. And put them up for the morning service. Let's come around this altar and ask God to help us. Please get the sick in here. You know, if you have to call people from other places that need help, we're using these night services to try to get people close to the Lord and bring deliverance to the captive. Come and let's have a good prayer. Don't let this scare you. Just let it cause you to do like that. It scares me. Frightens me. I just want to be saved. I quit a long time. Let's come in here and get on our knees or stand if you want to. God will help you to get ready for the coming of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God will help you to get ready for the beast. Brother White's going to come and lead us in prayer here. Come and get your sick in here this evening. I hope I don't have to do this tomorrow.
Praise
I want to get on the gifts, you know. But the main thing, we got to get in here and get this mind right. Come on, let's pray.
Praise the Lord. Everybody, we should be in this altar. Praise God. Let's offer ourselves to the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, this is what you're trying to get us to do, to return to you, God. Lord, you said if we'd return unto you, that you'd return to us. Father, we come to this altar this afternoon, offering our bodies, offering ourselves, Lord, rending our hearts and not our garments. Oh, God, help us today, Lord. Don't let this be.